Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen.
I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been.
Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here.
I'm on the top of the world again, down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Try them. one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride, but something touched me deep inside the day the music died. So bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. And them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, "This'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die." Did you write the book of love? And do you have faith in God above? If the Bible tells you so, do you believe in rock and roll? Can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow? Shoes. Man, I dig those rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage bronc and buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. But I knew I was out of luck the day the music died. I started singing, "Bye, bye, Miss American Pie." Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Day that I die, this'll be the day that I die. Now for 10 years we've been on our own, and moss grows fat on a rolling stone, but that's not how it used to be. When the jester sang for the king and queen in a coat he borrowed from James Dean, and a voice that came from you and me. Oh, and while the king was looking down, the jester stole his thorny crown. The courtroom was adjourned, no verdict was returned. And while Lennon read a book on Marx, a quartet practiced in the park, and we sang dirges in the dark. The day that I die. Help the skelter in the summer swelter. The birds flew off with a fallout shelter, 8 miles high and falling fast. It landed foul on the grass. The players tried for a forward pass with the jester on the sidelines in a cast. The halftime clenched in fists of rage. No angel born in hell could break that Satan's spell. And as the flames climbed high into the night to light the sacrificial rite, I saw Satan laughing with delight. The day the music died, he was singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die, this'll be the day that I die. I met a girl who sang the blues, and I asked her for some happy news, but she just smiled and turned away. I went down to the sacred store where I'd heard the music years before, but the man there said the music wouldn't play. And in the streets the children screamed, the lovers cried and the poets dreamed, but not a word was spoken. The church bells all were broken, and the three men I admire most, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, they caught the last train for the coast the day the music died. And they were singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. And them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die, this'll be the day that I die. They were singing bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die.
This song's called Alice's Restaurant. It's about Alice and the restaurant. But Alice's Restaurant is not the name of the restaurant. That's just the name of the song. And that's why I called the song Alice's Restaurant. You can get anything you want at Alice's Restaurant. You can get anything you want at Alice's Restaurant. Walk right in, it's around the back, just a half a mile from the railroad track. And you can get anything you want at Alice's Restaurant. Now it all started two Thanksgivings ago, it was on 2 years ago on Thanksgiving, when my friend and I went up to visit Alice at the restaurant. But Alice doesn't live in the restaurant, she lives in the church nearby the restaurant, in the bell tower with her husband Ray and Fatsha the dog. And living in the bell tower like that, they got a lot of room downstairs where the pews used to be. And having all that room, seeing as how they took out all the pews, they decided that they didn't have to take out their garbage for a long time. We got up there, we found all the garbage in there, and we decided it'd be a friendly gesture for us to take the garbage down to the city dump. So we took the half a ton of garbage, put it in the back of a red VW microbus, took shovels and rakes and implements of destruction, and headed on toward the city dump. Well, we got there and there's a big sign and a chain across the dump saying closed on Thanksgiving. And we had never heard of a dump closed on Thanksgiving before. And with tears in our eyes, we drove off into the sunset looking for another place to put the garbage. We didn't find one till we came to a side road, and off the side of the side road was another 15-foot cliff, and at the bottom of the cliff was another pile of garbage. And we decided that one big pile's better than two little piles, and rather than bring that one up, we decided to throw ours down. That's what we did. Drove back to the church, had a Thanksgiving dinner that couldn't be beat, went to sleep and didn't get up until the next morning when we got a phone call from Officer Obie. Said, kid, we found your name on an envelope at the bottom of a half a ton of garbage and just wanted to know if you had any information about it. And I said, yes, sir, Officer Obie, cannot tell a lie. I put that envelope under that garbage. After speaking to Obie for about 45 minutes on the telephone, we finally arrived at the truth of the matter and said that we had to go down and pick up the garbage and also had to go down and speak to him at the police officer station. So we got in the red VW microbus with the shovels and rakes and implements of destruction, headed on toward the police officer station. Now, friends, there was only one or two things that Obie could have done at the police station, and the first was that he could have given us a medal for being so brave and honest on the telephone, which wasn't very likely, and we didn't expect it. Another thing was that he could have bawled us out and told us never to be seen driving garbage around the vicinity again, which is what we expected. But when we got to the police officer station, there was a third possibility that we hadn't even counted upon, and we was both immediately arrested, handcuffed. And I said, Obie, I don't think I can pick up the garbage with these handcuffs on. I said, shut up, kid. Get in the back of the patrol car, and that's what we did, and sat in the back of the patrol car and drove to the, quote, scene of the crime, unquote. I want to tell you about the town of Stockbridge, Massachusetts, where this happened. Here they got three stop signs, two police officers and one police car. But when we got to the scene of the crime, there was five police officers and three police cars, being the biggest crime of the last 50 years. And everybody wanted to get in the newspaper story about it. And they was using up all kinds of cop equipment that they had hanging around the police officer station. They was taking plaster, tire track, footprints, dog smelling prints, and they took 27 8x10 color glossy photographs with circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one explaining what each one was to be used as evidence against us. Took pictures of the approach, the getaway, the northwest corner, the southwest corner, and that's not to mention the aerial photography. After the ordeal, we went back to the jail. Obie said he was gonna put us in the cell. Said, kid, I'm gonna put you in the cell. I want your wallet and your belt. And I said, Obie, I can understand you want my wallet so I don't have any money to spend in the cell, but what do you want my belt for? And it said, kid, we don't want any hangings. Said, Obie, did you think I was gonna hang myself for littering? Obie said he was making sure, and friends, Obie was, because he took out the toilet seat so I couldn't hit myself over the head and drown. And he took out the toilet paper so I couldn't bend the bars, roll the toilet paper out the window, slide down the roll, and have an escape. Obie was making sure, and it was about 4 or 5 hours later that Alice, remember Alice? It's a song about Alice. Alice came by and with a few nasty words to Obie on the side, bailed us out of jail. We went back to the church, had another Thanksgiving dinner that couldn't be beat, and didn't get up until the next morning when we all had to go to court. We walked in, sat down. Obie came in with the 27 8x10 covered glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back each one. Sat down. Man came in, said, all rise. We all stood up, and Obie stood up with the 27 8x10 covered glossy pictures, and the judge walked in, sat down with the C&I dog, and he sat down. We sat down. Obie looked at the C&I dog. Then the 27 8x10 covered glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one, and looked at the C&I dog. And then at the 27, 8x10, colored glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one, and began to cry, cause Obie came to the realization that it was a typical case of American blind justice, and there wasn't nothing he could do about it. And the judge wasn't gonna look at the 27, 8x10, colored glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one, explaining what each one was to be used as evidence against us. And we was fined $50 and had to pick up the garbage in the snow, but that's not what I came to tell you about. Came to talk about the draft. You got a building down New York City, it's called Whitehall Street, where you walk in and you get injected, inspected, detected, infected, neglected, and selected. I went down to get my physical examination one day, and I walked in, I sat down, got good and drunk the night before, so I looked and felt my best when I went in that morning. Cause I wanted to look like the all-American kid from New York City. Man, I wanted to feel like the, I wanted to be the all-American kid from New York. And I walked in, sat down, I was hung down, brung down, hung up, and all kinds of mean, nasty, ugly things. And I walked in, I sat down, they gave me a piece of paper, said, kid, see the psychiatrist, room 604. And I went up there, I said, shrink, I want to kill. And I want to kill. I want to see blood and gore and guts and veins in my teeth. Eat dead, burnt bodies. I mean, kill. And I started jumping up and down, yelling, kill. And it started jumping up and down with me, and we was both jumping up and down, yelling, kill. And the sergeant came over, pinned the medal on me, sent me down the hall, said, you're our boy. Didn't feel too good about it. Proceeded on down the hall, getting more injections, inspections, detections, neglections, and all kinds of stuff that they was doing to me at the thing there. And I was there for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. I was there for a long time, going through all kinds of mean, nasty, ugly things, and I just having a tough time there. And they was inspecting, injecting every single part of me, and they wasn't leaving no part untouched. Proceeded through, and I went, finally came to see the very last man. I walked in, sat down after a whole big thing there, and I walked up and said, what do you want? He said, kid, we only got one question. Have you ever been arrested? And I proceeded to tell him the story of Alice's restaurant, Massacre, with full orchestration and five-part harmony and stuff like that. And then all the phenomena stopped me right there and said, kid, did you ever go to court? And I proceeded to tell him the story of the 27, 8x10, colored glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one, and stopped me right there and said, kid, I want you to go over and sit down on that bench that says Group W. Now, kid! And I walked over to the bench there, and there's Group W is where they put you. If you may not be moral enough to join the army after committing your special crime, and there was all kinds of mean, nasty, ugly-looking people on the bench. There's mother rapers, father stabbers, father rapers. Father rapers sitting right there on the bench next to me, and one, it was mean and nasty and ugly and horrible and crime-fighting guys are sitting there on the bench. And the meanest, ugliest, nastiest one, the meanest father raper of them all, was coming over to me, and he was mean and ugly and nasty and horrible and all kinds of things. And he sat down next to me and said, kid, what'd you get? I said, I didn't get nothing. I had to pay $50 and pick up the garbage. He said, what were you arrested for, kid? And I said, littering. And they all moved away from me on the bench there, the hairy eyeball, and all kinds of mean, nasty things. till I said, and creating a nuisance. And they all came back, shook my hand, and we had a great time. On the bench talking about crime, mother stabbing, father raping, all kinds of groovy things that we was talking about on the bench. And everything was fine, we were smoking cigarettes and all kinds of things until the sergeant came over. Had some paper in his hand, held it up and said, kids, this piece of paper's got 47 words, 37 cents, it's 58 words. We want to know details of the crime, time, the crime, and that kind of thing. Got a separate time to about the crime. Want to know the rest of the officer's name, and that kind of thing. You got to say, and talk for 45 minutes, and nobody understood a word that he said. But we had fun filling out the forms and playing with the pencils on the bench there. And I filled out the massacre with the four-part harmony and wrote it down there just like it was, and everything was fine. And I put down a pencil and I turned over the piece of paper, and there on the other side, in the middle of the other side, away from everything else on the other side, in parentheses, capital letters, quotated, read the following words. Kid, have you rehabilitated yourself? I went over to the sergeant and said, Sergeant, you've got a lot of damn gall to ask me if I've rehabilitated myself. I'm sitting here on a bench. I mean, I'm sitting here on a Group W bench. Because you want to know if I'm moral enough to join the army, burn women, kids, houses, and villages after being a litter bug. He looked at me and said, Kid, we don't like your kind. And we're going to send your fingerprints off to Washington, and friends. Somewhere in Washington, enshrined in some little folder, is a study in black and white of my fingerprints. And the only reason I'm singing you the song now is because you may know somebody in a similar situation. Or you may be in a similar situation, and if you're in a situation like that, there's only one thing you can do, is walk into the shrink wherever you are. Just walk in, say, shrink. You can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant and walk out. You know, if one person, just one person does it, they may think he's really sick and they won't take him. And if two people do it in harmony, they think they're both faggots and it won't take either of them. And if three people do it, can you imagine three people walking in, singing a bar, Alice's restaurant, and walking out? They may think it's an organization. And can you imagine 50 people a day? I said 50 people a day walking in, singing a bar, Alice's restaurant, and walking out. And friends, they may think it's a movement. And that's what it is, the Alice's Restaurant Anti-Massacre Movement. And all you gotta do to join is to sing it the next time it comes around on the guitar with feeling. So we'll wait till it comes around on the guitar here. Sing it when it does. Here it comes. You can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. You can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. Walk right in, it's around the back, just a half a mile from the railroad track. And you can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant.
That was horrible.
Want to end war and stuff, you gotta sing loud. You could put a lot. I've been singing the song now for 25 minutes. I could sing it for another 25 minutes. I'm not proud or tired.
So we'll wait till it comes around again, and this time with four-part harmony and feeling. We're just waiting for it to come around is what we're doing. Can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant, excepting Alice. You can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. So walk right in, it's around the back, just a half a mile from the railroad track. And you can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. Da 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 da. At Alice's restaurant.
inside of me goes back through the years, and I'm a kid I used to know. I'm flying over my shoulder through the dust. I'm calling, run wild and catch me if you can. On any Sunday
I was on my bike, running to a friend named Mike. Running to a friend named Mike. Mike no longer has a bike, he cries. I don't want a pickle. I just want to ride my motorcycle. I'd rather ride on my motorcycle. And I don't want to die, just want to ride on my motorcycle.
Chicago.